there's a quick little update on this guy. Bit by bit, I've been trying to find and collect parts to get this thing back in shape. So I found a pair of doors. Got a new top on it. And I found a back seat. Still trying to figure out what I'm going to do for front seats. But to start, the doors are in pretty good shape that I found. Surprisingly, they're the same teal color under the black rattle can as the body is. Besides that, I think I showed before I pulled the motor out. And I'm getting that cleaned up and prepped to go into my other car. And then as soon as it's ready, as soon as I lift the motor out of the white car, it'll just drop directly into this one. I found a set of DeLordo side drafts and a manifold, a complete setup. That's gonna end up going on that built 1.3 and into this car. That's pretty much it. I've bought a couple of little things like new taillights, little things like that. Not sure what I'm gonna do for bumpers. I may build ones like I built on the gray car, but I might try something different too. So that's pretty much it for now. Keep watching marketplace, and as I find different parts, just trying to scoop up what I can, get this thing back on the road. It's too good of a car really to have sat this long, so I'm excited to get it back on the road. All right, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. Well, here's the motor. I figured I'd show that too. Kind of sitting over here in the corner. If you saw the video where I got the thing fired up and running, the only major issue it seemed to have was the water pump is spewing coolant out of the weep hole. And then as I took it apart, this fuel pump, a water pump inlet pipe was totally rotted out. So I got a new one of those, new water pump, new timing set. And then I've been slowly cleaning it up. It's a total greasy mess. Oh, I put a new seal in behind the cam sprocket. That seal was blown and this whole thing was full of oil inside. And it looks like the valve cover gasket was pretty weepy too. So I'm gonna get this all scrubbed down and cleaned up. And besides that, it's about ready to drop into my White Samurai. Like I said, this is just a bone stock motor. I'm gonna see if I can borrow a bore scope and look down inside. I assume it's got dish pistons. It's hard telling with these things, you never know. I'm kind of hoping it is because this is getting a turbo on it. And like I said, the motor coming out of my White Samurai now, it's got higher compression and a big cam. And so it's gonna get those Weber or DeLordo side drafts on it and go into the little Black Samurai. And that should make a pretty screaming little motor. And then this one with the stock cam and the turbo should give me a little more better bottom end for crawling through the rocks. And then the turbo for the top end, the high speed stuff. My goal with the little black one is be more or less like a daily driver. I'm gonna lift it some. I'm actually kicking around the idea of building a link kit. So I may do some prototype work with that on that car. I wanna keep the lift fairly low on it though, like maybe like 3 inches of lift. What I'm really after more than anything is just a really good ride on the street. So I'll either go with coils or little coilovers. I'm not sure yet, but anyway, that's it. Probably the next thing I show will be getting the motor stuck back in it, hopefully soon, and getting it fired up again. All right, thanks for watching.